Hey y'all, today I'll be unboxing my new sleeping bag because we're doing this kids thing and now I'm gonna sleep on the floor, so new sleeping bag.
Yes, it was.
Did Mr. Murphy sign a lease?
No, he would not. I bottle these? Look, if he would not.
So he didn't sign it? No. He was a month to month tenant. And how long did he stay?
The end of June, the very last day of June of 2018.
So far, is that correct?
Correct.
And what was your rent, sir?
$500 a month.
And in September, October, November, December, January, February, March, April, May, did you pay rent?
Yes, ma'am.
Is that correct?
No.
Which month did he not pay?
He stopped paying, I do believe.
Yeah, I got my sleep.
Did you pay by
$600 a month, including utilities?
Did you pay by check or cash?
I always pay by cash.
Where did you get the cash from?
The bank.
So you would make withdrawals from the bank?
Correct.
So at the beginning of each month, there would be a withdrawal for the $500?
Correct.
So, Mr. Murphy, you moved in September 2017?
Yeah, like the middle of September, yeah.
And you moved out on what date?
I believe it was like the 31st, according to my text messages, of May.
So we should have rent for October, November, December, January, February, March, April, at least 7 or 8 months?
Yes.
Okay. And do you have that?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I'd like to take a look at it.
I don't understand.
So on April 7th,
how many days I've been waiting for this?
I don't see any.
They're gonna be so surprised, y'all.
On April, my buddy helped me out because I had truck problems. I have all the other months.
February 27th, I have a $500 withdrawal. On the 18th of January, I have a $500 withdrawal. Well, then I have two withdrawals.
Okay, let's put it back.
One for $300 on the 29th of December, and one on January 2nd for $200. That is 1 month. I'm not sure. If you moved in the middle of the month, you were probably paying your rent at the middle of the month. You certainly weren't prepaying your rent on the 17th of the month for the next month.
I pulled the money out.
1, 2, 3 months, 4 months. This is October, 5 months. And here again, we have on the 29th. And the first, two different payments. So I have 6 months, seven. So we're missing 1 month.
Correct.
Okay. Property damage. Miss Delano, tell me when you experienced property damage caused by Mr. Murphy.
Starting. I also have a video of him damaging my property as well. There's a video of him doing all kinds of damage to my security cameras, which he has managed to break. Both of them, I have receipts for them, and he's knocked them down. And
so that's the property damage that you told me?
No. All my doors, he kicked in the two front doors, which were just put in the day before. He damaged all the deadbolt locks on the doors. I have police reports here stating that he damaged the deadbolts, that they said that he damaged them, and all the frames of
Did
all the doors.
Did you try to lock him out? Ms. Delano?
He was caught stealing from me.
Just a second. You tried to lock him out?
He was caught, yes.
Then the answer is yes.
Yes.
Without evicting him?
Yes. I was told that by the police department.
No, you can't tell me what the police department told you.
Okay.
That's hearsay.
Okay.
And I don't believe it.
I understand.
Just so that you know, once you have a tenant, if you're having problems with the tenant, you have to go through an eviction process. You can't just change the doors and the locks. You can't resort to self-help. And it's not something that the police would ever tell you if you said, I have a tenant that I want out who's paying their rent. They would never say you changed the locks on them. They just wouldn't do it. Okay. Now, I'll see your video.
This shows how much damage he was doing and the violence and all the he was bringing in. My business was in my house, and he was not allowed to bring in any people at all because that's the girl stealing my necklace that he went to my bedroom and got, apparently, according to the paperwork. That's the girl that was stealing my bank statements with him. That's her taking a bath of my stuff, leather, and hardware. That's my studio. You see how heavy the bag is? It's filled with a lot of heavy belts, buckles, and stuff like that. Bringing in people that are scared that nobody's allowed in my house at all because of my business. It's not even a girl or a guy. I don't know what that is. This is him knocking over my security cameras. And they can steal from me. Look how vicious. Look. That's what he did every day. Oh, my kidding. He's fine about them. walking out the door also has some of my stolen property that he took out of my office. Belts. I'm wearing both my leather belts. He's probably wearing one of my belts right now. There goes my out the door.
That's not funny. That's not funny. I'm not amused.
It's not funny.
Well, then why did you appear to be enjoying it?
I'm not.
I mean, the look of it is that you were stealing her property and damaging her property, sir. That's what it looks like. To me, that's what it looks like. Actually, that's also what it looks like to everybody out there watching, including Officer Burge. So why would you think that that's amusing?
I'm not laughing at all.
Good.
I'm
actually... You're responsible for all of that.
That... Can I explain that video? The first person in that video is not even me. And that last one is me when I'm moving out of the apartment.
Are you telling me that the person that I saw trying to break the security cameras wasn't you?
No, that's me turning the camera. That's me turning the camera. Absolutely.
Where's your room?
Third floor.
And who are those women that you had in the house with jewelry?
That's not me in that first video.
I'd like to take a look at it. Can I see it again?
Sure.
Well, it wasn't her, and you're the only two people that live there. So she didn't bring somebody in. That means somebody...
There were no girls. Nobody was allowed in my house. Looks like you to me.
Oh, maybe it is. Okay. I still do not take anything from her.
Judging for the plaintiff and the amount of $5,000, you count the claims dismissed. We're done.
Parties are excused. You may step out.
Oh, it was wonderful because everything he said was wrong.
She got evicted from that place because she harassed me so much and she called the police so much.
He was stealing from me. He was stealing all my leather pants, leather belts that I custom made.
Okay, so y'all.
Front lawn when she illegally evicted me.
This is my new sleeping bag. I was
going to
order that
Pandora,
but I didn't.
All parties in the matter of Mackie versus Burmeister.
Thank you.
Debbie Mackie is suing her neighbor.
Thank you, Walmart, for letting me spend my money, $27 for a sleeping bag.
And trespassing.
Miss Mackie, sometime last year, you got power of attorney over a property that your aunt was living in.
Your Honor, I actually obtained power of attorney for her in 2010, starting. The power of attorney that I recently got was in January of 2018 to take care of her as well.
Thank you, Walmart, but also this. Like, for a sleeping bag, bro?
Where is she living now?
She's living with me.
Does your aunt have anybody assisting her?
My side.
Other than you?
My family.
So she lives with you unassisted?
I mean, she lives with us. I take care of her and my dad. My dad's in a wheelchair. He's 88, so I'm pretty much their full-time caretaker.
Who's with them now?
My daughter.
And where is this property that you took over in January?
The property is in Crockett, California, which is in the Bay Area.
Is it a single-family home?
It's actually a triplex. She lived in the single-family home. It has a single-family residence above and what used to be the old barber shop of the town on the left and on the other side, which she uses as a basement or used as a basement. It was the previous dry cleaner many years ago.
And if you had the property valued?
No, I have not recently. I am...
Thank you. But not thank you, Walmart. I could have bought one from Target.
The value based Target. On the condition right now is basically
but I chose you.
And you have renovation plans.
I absolutely do.
Can I change the
mattress? Yes.
Yes.
$27. Right look, now, the sleeping bag costs $19.
To build the deck and to take care of some of the dry rot.
But it says free shipping. But a fee for $20.
What is your plan for the property?
To rehab it.
19, you went over 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27.
How long have you been at your premises? I had to be
8 more. I own the building next door, the Emporium from 1922.
Do you live there as well?
I'm
gay. Okay. But okay. Because I still got it. I'm still grateful.
To you, Mr. Burmeister.
Y'all, that big old bump, I stepped on the box.
No longer
by accident.
And of course, to you, Miss Mackey's aunt gave you permission to store the stuff on her property.
Correct, Your Honor.
That doesn't exist anymore. I'm explaining that to you. That doesn't exist anymore.
Judge Judy continues in a moment.
How am I supposed to say much is going to take to get rid of the junk?
I just want him to get it out of there.
He says it's not junk. Hold on. Pay attention. You say it's not junk. You say
and it is on my property, Your Honor.
Get out of here, boy. I don't want you, boy. I already got my sleeping bag. And if my sleeping bag cheat on me,
you've got a lot on your mind. We'll put a lot of your the new Zach's family packs with your choice of 20 chicken or 30 homeless eggs.
Bye, y'all.